Sweet children, you Brahmins are protectors of the sacrificial fire. It is this sacrificial fire that will give you the fruit you desire. In these next few moments, consider Baba's words and what they mean for you. What does it mean for you to be a protector of the sacrificial fire? In what way did you today protect the sacrificial fire with love? And why are you protecting this fire? Baba says that by protecting this fire, you will get the fruit you desire. What is the fruit you desire, the deepest desire of your heart? And for these next few moments, as we gaze into the fire and listen to its crackling sound, let's reflect on our experience. How has my loveful protection of this fire of purity, this fire of purification inside of me, how has that been giving me day after day, week and month after week and month, and year after year, how has that been giving me the fruit I have always desired? Sit with Baba for this reflection.
Thank you.
Baba says, let go of all your worries and serve the sacrificial fire with love. Imbibe this knowledge. There has to be great peace in this godly ashram. I consider my own mind to be a godly ashram. I sit with my mind in beautiful stable constant peace.
Thank you.
This is the time where the part of Draupadi is being enacted practically. This is the time that because we did call out to God for such a long period, that Baba has come. He heard our cries, and right at the moment where we had reached our most vulnerable, our lowest state of being, He's come. He has come to protect me. The way in the story of Draupadi, her dignity was maintained by the sari that just kept wrapping around her, protecting her honor, while there were those energies of the world that would have stripped her honor away. Her faith in God protected her, just as my faith protects me from any of these energies in the world stealing my honor, robbing me of my dignity, my pure self-respect of being Baba's child, of being an old gold soul. These jewels of knowledge sit in the golden vessel of my intellect and make all the words I speak and all the thoughts I have golden in nature, infused with spiritual truth from my beloved. And like the rose, I am full of the fragrance of spirituality as I experience God's love flowing into me. nourishing the core of my being. And removing the darkness that has taken up residence in my mind by illuminating all the hidden aspects of the soul. And while some of these dark corners may hold unseemly things, weaknesses, body conscious habits that I am not proud of, I remain dignified and detached, knowing that those thorns are there, but they need not influence me anymore. I am detached from all the limitations of bodies and material-mindedness, and am therefore not influenced anymore by thorns, either my own or those in the world around me, because I am a spiritual rose. I am full of the fragrance of spirituality. I am loved by God, and I love my true self.